Guys, so we're back. And let's have a look at the map. So we're making our escape from Grimsby Harbour, and there's this destroyer and this destroyer that are coming to get us because we've sunk five merchant vessels. So we're submerged at periscope depth, and we need to get away basically. So let's have a look. So we've no torpedoes, and we've got no ammo for the deck guns, so we really just need to get the hell out of here. Right, so my plan is to go to Heligoland. I don't really want to go all the way back to Germany, but Heligoland seems pretty close, and it's not too far, so I don't have to go back through the canal, for instance. So that's the plan. And we need to get the hell out of here before these destroyers get us. So let's nip on the observation periscope. Sorry. There we go. Let's see if we can see this guy. So he should be down here. There he is. Doesn't have a clue where we are, which is good. The other guy is miles away. He's way over here. He's so far away, I can't even see him. So, we're gonna get out of here. There's gonna be a lot of slow speed maneuvering. So, I don't think you guys want to watch that. So, I'll come back to you in a few seconds once we get out of probably the mouth of the bay. Okay, guys, catch you in a few seconds. Hello, people. So we're in Heligoland. Just show you the map. That's us there. And that is the harbour in front of us. So, let's go and get refitted. Sorry guys, just messing around with the microphone there. Anyway, yeah. Map. Get in here, I suppose. I don't know.
New waypoint. Course 47. Returning to course.
Speed up time a wee bit.
Ship sighted. Bearing 3, 2, 4.
See if we can get some more torpedoes and see if we can't upgrade the boat a wee
bit.
We
are in
and then go
shallow
and
waters,
finish off this
Captain.
campaign. It was actually a pain getting out of the harbour in the end. It took
All
about
stop.
40 minutes or something. So, can I actually do anything here? What's that? Ah, dock at Heligoland. Refit, that's what we want. Okay, let's see, what have we got now? Torpedoes. Oh, yeah. Cool. So, a rack of torpedoes. Subsystems 100%. Hull integrity is still 78%, which is a bit annoying. I wonder if I can give me any other option. Yeah, I know I need to go and do my patrol. Oh God, see, I know about this. Go away. What's this? Yeah, I know. Go away. I know how to move about. Oh, these things are so annoying. Anyway, so I think that's all we can do. So we haven't had the hull refitted or anything, but we can just get out of here and go back and kill some stuff. So let's get a course set, guys.
New waypoint, course 292.
Returning to course. New waypoint. Course 251.
Half speed.
New waypoint. Course 169.
Pressure hull.
New waypoint. Course 125.
Pressure hull repaired.
Oh dear.
All
stop.
2-1. Ready.
Oh my god. These guys are just unbelievable. They've just driven straight into the fucking pier. Guys, I plotted a course for a reason. Right, okay, so let's do this manually. Nope, wrong button. F2. Let's reverse out, I suppose. Actually, what damage have these idiots done? Subsystems. Hull integrity 39%. Oh god. Shit. That's not good. Let's have a look at the map. See if we can find a sub base anywhere near Kiel. It's just Kiel, I think. There's nothing closer. Oh. So now I only need to sink another couple of ships. I might just go for it. 39% is okay, especially going for merchants. I mean, if I sneak back across here, and if I just go back to the harbour, I could sink another two ships and that's us done. I'm not sure yet. Okay, let's have a look. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. I can't be bothered heading all the way to Kiel. So, we are going to reverse out, guys.
Ready.
So, we want to go
back slow
that way. Let's see. Should just be able to back straight out, I think. Plenty
we
of
are
room.
In shallow waters, Captain.
Yeah, that looks okay. So I don't know how interesting this is for you guys, but my crew nearly trashed my sub. That's cool though, we're making a nice turn. We should be alright. The external camera is very handy for this, if not a bit cheaty. But that looks good. That looks really good. Yeah, we're gonna miss that wall. Fine. And then back to the harbour and destroy some stuff, I think, guys. So I think we're gonna stop. All stop.
All stop.
Okay. Let's go and have a look. Where's the eraser? It is there. Let's get rid of that. So that's that waypoint gone. Oh, wrong button. I keep doing that.
2-3. Ready.
Don't want that anymore. So let's go.
New waypoint. Course 4.
All stop.
New waypoint. Course 13. Returning
all
to course.
Stop. Half speed ahead. All
let's
stop.
See if we can
we're reaching course end. New waypoint. Course 3. New waypoint. Course 55.
Slow speed.
Oh, God. Guys, stop repeating everything. Bloody hell. It wouldn't be so bad if they hadn't driven the thing into the bloody pier. Now, is that turn too tight? Let's go and have a look. I think it's probably okay. Yeah, I think they're fine. Eventually, we're going to get out. If we miss that wall, we should do. Nearly there now. Oh yeah, who'd have thunk it? We nearly sunk ourselves. After that, after sinking six ships, we nearly killed ourselves. But I bet stuff like this happened all the time. I mean, I'd be very surprised if there weren't accidents at anchor. Just with the amount of munitions and fuel and guys wandering about, especially if you've been away at sea for like 100 days and then you get back on shore and the first thing you do is get wrecked.
two, four.
Well, if you're
ready.
Scottish. and knowing a few Germans and having lived with a German, they do like to drink. Right, let's see. Can we get out of here? Looks good. I think we're alright, guys. So there we go. Lesson learnt. Don't set intricate courses in a harbour. Just get out slowly. Right. Come on, guys. So I think we're good. I think we're right. Yeah,
ship sighted.
Okay.
Bearing 295.
Let's have a look. My battery should be recharged. Subsystems. Battery level 100%. That's great. For some reason, it was charging really slowly in combat. But we shall see how it goes. Right. Okay. Let's set a course, and then
we're approaching
our
final waypoint.
When we've gotten somewhere interesting. So we should be here. Let's go out.
New waypoint.
There.
Course 315. Returning to course. Half speed ahead.
Let's go along here. Because I pretty much know where I want to go. Yeah, let's go down there.
New waypoint. Course.
And I might
two,
sneak
three,
back into
nine.
Grimsby and just sink a few ships. I know it's a bit dull, but it'll get this part of the mission done. And then we can get some points and get some more stuff added onto the submarine so we can do a bit more. Okay, guys. Let's go back outside. So, I think I'll come back to you when we get closer to England, unless something happens on the way.
Escort.
So I'll be back in a few seconds.
We are in shallow.
Okay, guys, so we're just off the coast of Grimsby. I'll show you just now. Here, there are two merchant vessels, but there's this destroyer or warship. So we need to get in here and take them out, basically. How deep is the water?
Depth under keel is 90 meters, Captain.
So that's okay. It's enough. Luckily, it's a bit choppy, so. Should be okay. Can't quite see this warship, but it is out there. It's just out of my range. Wondering what time it is. Let's go down. It's 4 o'clock in the morning, so it's difficult. I don't want to submerge the boat unless I have to. I'm quite happy to sit in the bottom during the day, but not at night. So let's go all ahead. See how far we can sneak in like this, guys. But that is what's happening at the moment. So we need to sneak past this destroyer. I think last time I just kind of sat on the bottom here. My worry is that this time I've only got 39%. Hull integrity, so I don't know what that translates to in depth. I'm sure that has some sort of impact on how far we can dive and how long we can stay under, but we'll find out. It's going to be interesting times, but I really want to get back in here because all I need to sink. I mean, if I can sit off here, I can sink like 3 or 4 vessels. And that'll easily finish off this patrol. Where are we now? Yeah, sink 50,000 tons. I'm already at 42,000. So I've only got, like, realistically, 2 more boats. We'll see this done well before the deadline of June the 1st. Then we can move on and do something else. But at the moment, we are stuck here. So I'll come back to you when we have something else to show. Bye. guys, so coming back to you because on our way in, we're being hounded. I zoom out. There's destroyers right on top of us, so I'm at zero speed and we're just sitting still, hoping that we can just wait this out. This destroyer is after us. You can hear him actively pinging away. I've rigged for silent running. It's quite tense. Let's go to the external view. So there it is, look. There's the destroyer. We're pretty much just sat under there. Let's go down. I was looking. Oh, it's dropping depth charges. Put the periscope down out of the way. Hasn't quite found us yet though, but you can see he is after us, and remember our hull integrity is screwed, so we're sat there. I don't know how much water is underneath us.
Depth under keel is 24 meters, Captain.
No, we don't want that. No, no, no.
Periscope depth.
We want periscope depth. There's not enough depth here for us to really hide, guys. It's scary stuff. Go back up. I know this is totally cheating, but look, he's not giving up. Where is he going now? I mean, I can track him on the hydrophone, so I suppose I know where he's going. Right, so he's going in the opposite direction. So I think, where are we? Could do with just skirting around this guy. We zoom out. Okay, let's go down here, there, 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 there. All ahead, slope. There's three of them. One, two, three. Fortunately, I got picked up. I don't know how interesting this is going to be for you guys, but for me, it's pretty... It's very nerve-wracking, actually, to tell you the truth. It's, I don't like that active sonar. We're just inside his baffle range. We really want to be in here behind him so he can't hear us, but... Like I said, there's not a lot we can do. Can hear the guys, or everyone's a bit tense. Let's get on the hydrophone, see what we can hear. There he is. It's probably... Should be... Ah, yeah. There he is. All over us. Turning the volume up. So nerve-wracking times, guys. I might go and... Yeah, we're fine. Here, I'm going to shut some pressure hulls, just in case. We start to... We start to leak water. Close the one to the engine room as well. two open at the moment. They're easy to close. That, no, we won't close that. And we'll go along and close this one too. I'm being a bit paranoid. I think we'll be fine. It's just, oh man, I do not want to get caught. I mean, it kind of looks like, looking at this, he doesn't really know where we are. He's just searching. But we need to get out of here. The only way I can get out of here is at one knot, I reckon. Just hugging the bottom and making the best of it. So I'm going to do a bit of navigation, guys, and I will come back to you once I've got something to report, okay? Bye. Hello, people. So we're back. I managed to sneak around. It's just around dawn. I had to surface the boat to vent the CO2. It was getting up to about 20%, and I can't remember what level it becomes toxic at, but I couldn't sit on the bottom anymore. So the battery's doing okay. CO2 levels are zero again, which is good. And I'll show you where we are on the map. So we're down here. Another two destroyers out here. So in the end, I think we were about here, and I plotted a course down, and I kind of hugged the coast all the way in. There's still another destroyer up here, but it's not active. It's not actively hunting. So we're at like half speed. So we're just gonna continue on the surface to this waypoint. I don't know, it's 10:58, so it's a bit past dawn. So we're lucky because it's foggy. But yeah, we're just going to go to that waypoint, and then we'll probably submerge, and then we will take a course slowly, spend the day traveling up here. So we'll go from here up, and we'll sit in this area here. And then at night, we'll sink a couple of ships, and then we'll probably escape. Maybe try and come through this gap, although it looks really shallow. But if we could get through that gap, then it's just straight out into the North Sea, which would be good for us. So I think escaping is going to be the problem here, guys. So that's us. There is land. And you can see how misty it is. So it's definitely doing us some favors. So guys, I'm going to do some maneuvering, and then we'll come back to you when we're about to attack. See you in a few seconds. Hey guys, we're back. There is an escort sat right in our way. So I think we're going to try and sink it. It's 11:30, so we're just trying to ID the boat at the moment. So it's got two stacks, two guns at the back. See if we can finder here. One, two. It's not her. That's not her. That's not her. Now this might be the one. No, that's not her. At it. I think that might be it. Let's go for that. So I think we are going to take her out. If we just stop. So the way you do this, guys, is you have to match the numbers up, essentially. So it's the speed of my torpedoes, and that's what I would need to hit. So, three. She's not really moving that quickly. far away. I think it's worth taking the shot.
Firing 2-2.
Oh shit, that is gonna miss.
Torpedo depth set to 1 meter.
We are in shallow waters, Captain.
She's barely moving.
2-1, loose.
And now it's just a matter of waiting and hoping for the best. I can see at least one merchantman there. We need to get rid of this vessel because it can do nothing but annoy us all day. I cannot attack when there's a a cruiser or a destroyer like this just sat outside the harbor. So I'm kind of hoping these fish get there in time. I'm not sure. I'm going to speed up time a little bit. They're going to miss totally, I think. Maybe not. The first one should miss because it should go under it. The second one, I'm thinking, should hit. It's sat at anchor, so I'm kind of thinking we might be okay. Are we going to hit? It's missed. Unbelievable. I don't know how that missed, but it did.
Torpedo depth set to 1 meters.
Right, let's get this one. Let's fire again.
Firing 2-3.
This is costing me, guys.
Torpedo depth set to 1 meters.
Fire.
4.
Okay. Should hit because it's not moving. Speed up the old time.
Ready. Torpedo missed, sir.
I know it did. Now, pretty sure these are going to hit. I don't see how these can miss. Those are the two fish there. I set them to about 1.5 meters. So I'm kind of thinking they should definitely hit this thing. It's got a 3.1 meter. Beam, so not beam, keel, so it should hit it. Bang in the middle. Should hit now.
Torpedo.
Yeah, there we go. Sunk it, one torpedo.
3, ready.
So that was worth it.
Torpedo.
And whoa, the second one just made sure. Well, that's good because I did not, I didn't want to be attacking with a boat sat right there. I wonder if that registered for us. Let's have a look. It's a bit annoying though. I wasted 3 torpedoes essentially. What was that? 1,188 tons. So that's not too bad. How many torpedoes do I have left? Wrong one. Torpedoes. It's not too bad. It's 7 left. Should be more than enough to sink a few tankers and get us up to that total and complete this part of the game. Okay, so 11:36 torpedo impact. There's a couple of vessels probably come in to investigate, I would have thought. So we will come here, go there. So let's start moving, guys. When I'm in position, I'll come back to you. I just thought you'd be interested in seeing that. Okay, see you in a few seconds. Okay, guys, so let's have a look where we are. Oh, we are in the harbor. We're probably about 2 kilometers off the harbor. And we are going to destroy as much as we can, and then we're going to get out of here. So, let's get out of this view. Just about to put the periscope up. See where we are. I'm just going to use... I might try and save a couple of torpedoes, because I'm not going to be able to deck gun anything this time, because it's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So, lots of targets.
Ship sighted, Eric.
I'm just gonna go after the tankers because I need tonnage. So this one's gonna die first. We've locked it. I also repositioned myself so the bow is pointing at the harbor, just to make firing a bit easier. I mean, it shouldn't matter because these guys are sat still essentially. Anyway, never mind. Let's do that. Let's have a look. What kind of tanker is it? Pretty sure it'll be the same as the other ones. Kimmering class. Looks about right. 7,000 tons. Let's go for that. And let's turn this back on just so I can get the depth of the keel. Set it to 5.7. We'll put one right in our backside. See, fire. And then we'll put one in the middle, I think. Tube 2. We'll set this one a bit shallower. 5 meters. Fire. And now we're just waiting, guys. So I'm kind of hoping by the time I do this, maybe an hour will pass, be 5 o'clock, and then I can sneak away. I won't show you just now, but I'm going to sneak up. Actually, I can't. I'm going to sneak up here, try and come out that way, and then I will have to go back to Kiel and get repaired, because my hull is pretty trashed at the moment. And then I think that'll be it. Once we do the attack, I think that'll probably be it. This is going to be a long episode with everything that's happened, guys. But like all good U-boat commanders, I have coffee. Black coffee to keep me going. Let's zoom in. We should have an impact soon. So yeah, that one should hit her right in the stern, I'm hoping. Yeah, it's on course. We should see it here. Should hit her right there. Bang. There we go. Still got these annoying bars. Then we should get another one around about here. Bang. Boom. So I might actually put some more torpedoes into her just to make sure she's dead. Where will I put it? Put it here. Right in the bow. Because I can't surface in deck gunner. Let's have a look. What have I got left? Torpedoes. They'll leave me 3 for another ship, plus 1 in the rear that I want to keep for escaping. Right, okay, so let's fire. Need to get some better torpedoes. More explosive torpedoes would be good. These are okay, but I mean, it shouldn't take 3 torpedoes to sink a tanker, basically. Although I'm assuming these are unloaded, so they're probably not that flammable. But yeah, it's good fun. It's good fun, guys. Let's have a look, actually. Let's go external. External cheat cam. Well, let's go and see how she looks. See if we can see the damage. Oh, yeah. She's burning quite nicely. Right, let's go under the water. Is there any hole? Oh, aye. Big hole there. Big hole there. See inside. Should be another torpedo coming. See if we can catch it. Coming in here. Oh, can hear the alarms on the boats. Oh, it's quite freaky actually. Quite like to see the torpedo come in. Oh, there we go. Here it comes. Here it comes. Here it comes. Boom. Whoa! That was quite a big impact. Wow, she is totally on fire now. Right, that's cool. Wrong button. Let's go back to the boat. She's nearly dead. I cannot waste another torpedo on her. I need to make sure of a different target, so we'll switch target to this one. Turn that off, tanker. I know it's this. It's always that. Let's go back to you. Turn it on. Excellent. Make that a bit bigger. Yeah. That's fine. Just so I can see where we're shooting. So we're going to put 3 torpedoes in her, just to make sure, because I need the tonnage, 5 meters, fire, tube 3, we are going to put in the stern, and again we're going to reset the depth. I need to sync these things. And then we'll put another torpedo in right here, I think. That one's already set, so let's fire. So this is it, guys. I've got 1 torpedo left. Have a look. Yeah, 1 torpedo in the rear left, which I want to keep in case I need it on the way out. Kind of wasted a few torpedoes sinking that escort vessel, but I think it was worth it so that we could sit here in the afternoon and do this. Otherwise, we'd have had to wait quite a few hours. Anyway, let's see what happens. Let's have a look at the old map. Oh yeah, they're on their way, aren't they? That looks great. Let's see if we can. Yeah, that's her whole bang. That was pretty good. Should have another impact in a minute. Should be coming up. We might miss. We might have missed. Now we hit. Boom. And then we should have another impact quite soon. There we go. Bang. So these guys are nearly sunk. I might surface the boat. I need to have a look around, see if there's anyone around. There's no contacts. And there are no escort vessels. Look at all these merchant ships. It's unbelievable. That one is awake. Right, bugger it. Surface boat. And we'll deck gun them from now. I think that's the only thing we can do. Hopefully the deck gun will finish these guys off, and then we should be done. 43,000 tons. Merchant tonnage, 42. Warship tonnage, 1,000. Right, okay. Let's get up top, because I just want to get out of here. I do not like being above water in the broad daylight. There's the ships. Why is the periscope still up? Let's put that down. That just makes us look like a massive target. Honestly, if you don't do things yourself around here, nothing gets done. Right, let's get down. Let's get on the deck gun. Luckily, this fog is really helping us out at the moment. Right, I have no idea how far away she is. Block it. Oh no. That's not what it was, miles away. Fire. Oh, that hit, but... And that hit. Oh, high explosives. Okay, why not? Yeah, there we go. I think we're going to switch to armor piercing. We need to get some more holes in her. Get her sunk, I think. Let's go down to about there. Maybe a kilometer. Oh, I didn't see an explosion there, so it's probably at 1.1. Yeah, that seems to be where we need to be. So... that bit higher. I think a bit more concentration? Oh yeah, that's a hit. And the problem with being on the surfaces and doing this is that we are totally exposed. Which I don't particularly enjoy, but I need the tonnage. We need to get these guys sunk. If I hadn't have had to, well, I wasted effectively 3 torpedoes against that destroyer, as I said before, but we had to sink that. And it feels good actually sinking a war vessel instead of just picking on merchants the entire time. I'm not really picking where I'm shooting guys because there's so little health left on this vessel. I just need to sink it essentially. So that's it. Boom. Let's see if she's. Let's see if she's appearing as a wreck yet. Yep. So she's sunk. And then we'll move over to this one. And that was a hit. Which is good. It's all going well. So far, so good. We've got range on this one as well, which makes it easier. And although I've got plenty of ammo, as soon as these things are sunk, I'm getting out of here. I just want to get back to keel and... Whoa! That was a good shot. And refit, basically. So this should sink pretty soon, I would have thought. A couple more shots, maybe? Yeah, there we go. That's her sunk. Right, let's get back up here. Let's submerge the boat. Let's get out of here. I'm amazed how much we get away with sitting on the surface in broad daylight. Keep up the good work. Right, let's get downstairs. Let's go to periscope depth and get safe again. Periscope depth. So guys, I think we're probably going to leave it there and we'll pick it up. In episode 3 back at Kiel for some refitting. So yeah, hope you enjoyed the episode. Hope you're enjoying the series and I hope to see you again soon. Bye.